Hey everybody, this is John from Show Me Pickers, and today we are going to be going into the basement and pulling like 17 orders. I sold a ton of good stuff on eBay, but there is one item that I spent way too much time on and I really took a beating on. So if you have ever done the same thing, let me know down below in the comment section. Go down in the comments and leave me a message and let me know what that item was that you spent way too much time on or you spent too much money on because you didn't do your research. Let's get to the video. Thanks for watching. Try to catch me howling at the moon. Hello everyone, this is John and Megan, and today we are in the basement, and we are going to pull how many orders?
17
orders, so we're going to jump into that right now. Okay guys, this is the cross-stitch pattern that we sold. It sold for $50. I picked this up at an auction, and I didn't pay hardly anything for it. This is for a whole bedspread. Kind of cool. I wouldn't want to have to do it, but somebody is going to stay preoccupied over these cold winter months. Okay guys, this is the very next item that we have, and it is a very nice, not so very nice, but kind of nice. It is a saxophone. We sold it for $100. We actually sold it for $100, but the buyer meant to buy it with our 10% off that we sent out on it, but he bought it for full price. So what we're going to do is we're going to issue them a $10 credit on the item because we want to make sure they're happy. How much did we sell it for?
$99.95, and then they paid $18.95
shipping. $18.95
shipping
on this, so not too bad. I bought that at a auction for $25. The next item that I have here is this Fitz and Floyd's bunny plate. It is a breakable item, but fortunately it is in a box with styrofoam and everything. It's really cool, kind of cute. I didn't think it would sell till around Easter, but somebody must have had to have it right now. We paid $5 for it. We got that at a garage sale that was held underneath a Lutheran church. How much did it sell for?
$22 plus shipping.
Okay guys, this is the last one of these that we have. We had four of these Fisher-Price play sets to begin with, and this is the last one. This one was either, I think this is from the late 80s. We bought this at the dog thrift store where they use the money to help wayward puppies and kitties. So we paid somewhere in the neighborhood of like $3 for that. How much did it sell for?
$25 plus 10 shipping.
That's pretty awesome. These were really cool. We made a ton of money on these. I might have to make another donation to the dog shelter. Okay, this is the camcorder. Sorry about that. We had to run upstairs and find it. Of course, you don't know that. It is a Super VHS JVC camcorder. How much do we sell for?
$75 plus shipping.
So if you're ever out and you come across these JVC or Sony or Panasonic, these little VHSCs, pick them up. They're really good. People use them to transfer the old VHSC cassettes to digital media so that they can have them for the future. Right, Megan?
Yep.
Okay, I think we found it. This is a Climax food processor. It's a meat chopper. Really cool. We sold it for how much?
$16 plus shipping.
It's pretty heavy though, but it should go cubic because it's pretty small. That's one of the good things about items like this. This is it. It's got the little plates for the different kinds of foods that you process through. Connects to your countertop. Pretty neat. And was a quick ship. Okay, guys. These are all of the next items that we sold. We sold every one of these Looney Tunes puzzles. We sold them for how much?
$20 plus shipping.
So we got like 28 out of them. This was a time suck for me because I put every one of these together thinking they were going to be worth good money. And when I went to list them, I realized that they just were not worth as much as I thought. So don't make that mistake. Don't do this. Don't spend a lot of time on an item before you research. I've been reselling for 20 years, and that was my mistake. That is the purpose of this video, is to tell you to research your items before you put a lot of effort into them, like cleaning them, putting them together, making sure all the parts are there, because at the end of the day, you can realize that you just sunk a lot of time into something for absolutely nothing. Okay, so I am coming down to the wire on all this ham radio stuff. This is a Kenwood SP120 speaker. It is part of the ham radio buy that I made. We sold this for $150. Was there shipping on that, Megan?
No, it was $155 free shipping. $155
free shipping. This was absolutely amazing. I absolutely love that. That is a beautiful piece. $155 free. Okay, shipping. The next item that we sold here is this West Bend coffee pot. This was either, I'm going to call it like new or was new. Can you grab that for me, Megan? Because I am afraid that I'm going to drop it. I can't get it off the shelf. There we go. And we picked it up at a thrift store. And I think I only paid like $4 for it, $3 for it. It was brand new in the box. And we sold this thing. How much did we sell it for?
$55.
Woo! I almost dropped it. $55 for that, guys. Can you believe it? $55 for that 4-cup quick drip coffee maker. Are you excited about that? Mm-hmm. Yeah. See, she's so excited. Give me a happy face. There you go. Here we go. Here is the next item that we sold. Sorry, it's kind of dark down here, but this basement is really short. We sold this Bosch Electro-Hydraulic Proportional and Control Systems book. I did not honestly know if that would sell, but we did sell it for how much?
$25 plus shipping.
Not too bad for a book that I wasn't sure if it would sell or not. Okay, guys, we have an item in here, and it is this really cool Burns Security International Security Services. It is a badge. We sold it on eBay. I wasn't sure if I could sell it on there, but since it's a guard badge and it's not a police officer badge, I could. It's really cool. It's got the nice pin on the back of it. It's older. How much did we sell that for?
$15 plus $5 shipping.
$15 plus $5 shipping. So we got $20 out of that. Not too bad. Love it. Okay, guys. We have these How to Train Your Dragon figures here. They sold for how much?
$10 plus shipping.
$10 plus shipping. Not too bad. That's almost as good as that daggum security badge. I'm going to say that my wife has a sickness. Look at all these UPS postal boxes that we got over here, guys. You think that's a lot? Now look up here. Look at all of those boxes.
I like to be prepared.
That's a lot of boxes, and you're not a Boy Scout.
I like to be prepared.
That's pretty funny. I just had to show you guys that real quick because I thought it was kind of funny. This is our box bin location down here. These are just boxes that we pick up at random places. People put them out behind our store. So if you watch our videos and you live local, you are more than welcome to put your boxes out behind our store here. But we break them down, put them here. That's a big box that I dug out of the dumpster next door. But then we have all of our shipping supplies, our envelopes. We have several different size eBay boxes. That's what do we spend most of our money on whenever we do we do our credit? What do you buy mostly?
I buy all boxes. She buys eBay credit.
All boxes with the eBay credit.
Boxes usually.
Right,
because
right.
If you have to buy the smaller boxes from somebody, they're not as expensive.
Right, they're typically are cheaper. So that's a good advice as to if you're going to buy boxes, if you're going to buy something, the boxes to me are the best. If you have something else that you buy, let us know down below. What is it that you spend your credit on when you do your eBay shipping supplies? Like I said, my wife does boxes. She loves the boxes. We've got a ton of them. As you can see here, we've gotten into a lot of clothing. So my grand idea is that I'm going to take this back corner here. I'm actually going to take these bicycles and probably move them up to the front on the other side where I've got some places to store them and to hang them. And I'm probably going to get rid of most of this Christmas trees because I really don't need that many in a store my size. I'm going to get rid of some of these. And I'm going to put all of my clothing. I'm going to continue to put shelves through here and put clothing racks that I can hang from the ceiling because it's pretty low. There's already one bar right here that I can utilize. I can hang my clothing up down here. And the reason why I'm going to put it down here at this end of the store is because this is the driest end of the building. At the other end, there is a sump pump. And if you can see, my wife's box sickness continues right here. Okay, guys, this is everything that we sold here. The How to Train Your Dragon, the saxophone, the coffee pot, the cross stitch, the JVC camcorder, the speaker for your for the Kenwood speaker. We've got the little security badge. We've got the food chopper, the cute little bunny plate, all of these puzzles. We've got this Bosch book. We've got this Precious Moments. Then we've got a couple car parts here. This is the only thing really to speak of. These sold for $130. The rest of them are just $10 sales sprinkled in there. And the grand total of all of this is $723 plus shipping on top. Some of the stuff that's not exactly what we brought in, that's just what it sold for. Now, some of these items are shipping free. Not many. She's chomping at the bits to get boxes. Some of these are shipped free, but not many of them. So that's a pretty good number for 24 hours. This is not, you shipped everything out yesterday, right?
Yeah.
So this is just from the past 24 hours, we did $723 in sales. And most of the stuff I would not classify as Q4 Christmas items. Definitely is just random hodgepodge. Thrift shop stuff. That got me flustered, guys. When I get that cha-ching going, it gets me flustered. So there we go. I'll show you guys a couple things. I'm going to show you guys a couple things that we got upstairs. Go through a tote of some really cool stuff, and that'll be a video. Okay, guys. I just dug through all my Kung Fu magazines, and we just sold this Masters of Kung Fu. And it's pretty cool. I bought a bunch of these for like 50 cents a piece, I think. You remember how much I sold for just now?
$13.
I'll take that.
Hiya!
Karate deals. It's kind of nice, ain't it? Okay, guys, I wanted to show you a really cool item that I pick up quite a bit. I see them at thrift stores and antique malls all over the place. If I can get them for about 50 cents a piece, which I did, if you can see here, I've got a whole stack of them. I paid 50 cents a piece for all of these. There's like 25 of them here. Their MSRP is about $9.95 a piece, but they're the Great Illustrated Classic books. This one is The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn. We have Moby Dick, Call of the Wild, Little Women, Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde, 20 Leagues Under the Sea, Black Betty, so on and so forth. Just the classic illustrated books. They are adult novels dumbed down in a manner that a young child can consume and educate themselves with. And these sell pretty good. They sell typically for a set of 25, I'm going to get upwards of probably $75 out of them. And that's a really good bolo. So be sure that when you're out and about, if you see these books, if you find them in a lot, if you can find them in a large lot like this, be sure to pick them up, make a little bit of money. Okay, guys, and while we're on the subject of kids' books, I want to show you guys another lot of kids' books that I often do well with, and it is these Babysitter Club books. I know that they're very popular. Never read them myself. I was more of a boxcar kid kind of kid, but I do have a ton of these books here for sale. And I paid 50 cents a piece for them, and I'm not exactly sure how many are here, but I'm going to guess there's probably north of probably 50 books. And I believe that I typically get about $1.50 a piece out of them in a huge lot like this, and I've only got 50 cents a piece, so there is some good profit to be made here. I'm going to look them up real quick on the computer, this lot of books and the previous lot of books, so that we can kind of get an idea of exactly what we're looking at. Okay, I checked them over here on the computer, and a lot of 40 of them actually got 43 bids, and they sold for $208.50. There are 47 books here, so I am going to say that I was wrong, so I am going to have to take the big L on that one, but still, so instead of $75, you're probably looking northwards of $200 for these books. So if you're out and about and you see these, be sure to check them out. I wanted to show you real quick, if you're looking here on the screen, I'm sorry, it isn't the best way to show you guys stuff, but a lot of 25 of the Great Illustrated Classics sold for $75. So between the two, we're looking at about $300, and I paid 50 cents a book for roughly 75 books. So that's not a bad investment. It's a good return. So if you're ever out of Goodwill, this is something that a lot of people will look past. So be sure to be the smart one and pick them up. Okay, guys, I wanted to show you these tennis rackets that I've got here. These are wooden tennis rackets. They all have the wooden hoop around the outside, wooden handles, and these sell really well on online. They really do. I have a lot of these. I have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 of them, and I'm going to go over here on the computer. I'm going to pull up and show you what the 10 of these wooden tennis rackets sell for. It's pretty awesome.
Okay, guys, here is three listings. I only said a couple, but there are three listings here that I got pulled up. And if you look, the first set of 10 sold for $150. The next set sold for $80. And then this set right here sold for $150. So if you're ever out, you can typically find them at freaking Goodwills and stuff like that for $3 a piece. You'll have a $30 investment for 10 of them, and you can get upwards of $150 out of them. Now, the ones that I have aren't in that great of shape. I'll still probably be able to get about $100 out of them. I don't know what in the world people do with these. If you know, let me know down below, but that is a pretty good return on your money. Definitely hit that subscribe button for that bolo, because there's more where that one came from.
So I finally made it outside to check the mail, and I had a card waiting for me in the box. It's really cool. It's got a little Santa Claus with the, comes out of the card, and it's a little Christmas ornament. So that's going to go home, and it's going to go on the tree, and the card will go on our door with the rest of our Christmas cards. And it says, John and family, Merry Christmas, blessing for 2021. Thank you for everything you bring to the world. I appreciate you both, Danica. And she is awesome. She is a super sweet lady. She's from Texas. She is Lady Luck Junk. And I will put the link to her YouTube channel down below. She is so funny, and she makes fantastic YouTube videos. So you really need to check her out. She's a super awesome lady and makes great content. Thank you so much. It means a lot to us. It's actually going to go back here. I'm going to put it on here, maybe next to Kevin's Inaman or somewhere up here on top. So here we go. Okay, guys, let's go down to the basement here, and I'm going to show you what I've done. Oh, wow, look at all this. It's nice and clean. I do need to sweep up a little bit, but I'm going to do that tomorrow. I took all of these totes that were here that had cords in it. I threw away a whole tote of just worthless cords. I wasn't going to donate it because it was trash. And most likely somebody will dig it out of the dumpster anyway. So I did condense it down into two totes. I've got a couple of empty totes here. And then I've got a mess over here on the table that I'm going to take care of tomorrow. Or, well, today it's like 5 in the morning. So I'm going to get all of this cleaned out. I've got a ton of extra totes. I think I'm going to take some of the extra totes that I have, take them over to the thrift store and donate them. They can always sell them for a couple bucks or use them for storage. So that's everything in the video today. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please go down below and maybe hit that like button. Maybe even subscribe to the channel for more content and ring the bell for notifications so that you will know when we go live or when we upload new content. So I thank you very much for watching Show Me Pickers. You have a good day. God bless you guys. And remember, family that picks together, sticks together.